I find for most patients, even non-native patients, when the appetite starts to decrease and they're not taking in the food or they can't take in the food, it becomes a real worry for the families, maybe not so much the patient, but definitely the families. And it's about education, it's about giving people information and explaining that that is a natural part of the body process. And in fact, there has been research to show that as you become more dehydrated, the brain will release chemicals that actually give you a sense of well-being. And when people come to an understanding that, you know, this is natural, this is part of what's going to happen, it's not starving them. You're not doing anything wrong here. People oftentimes will start to feel better about the fact that their loved one is not eating so much. For some people, it remains a stressor right until the end of days. Our culture is about food and about sharing and respect for the elders, and when they can't have that, it feels like we're doing something wrong. So it's, again, validating where people are, how they feel, giving them the information, and encouraging them to know that they are doing a good job. And if the patient doesn't want to eat, that's okay. And if they want to have ice cream for breakfast, that's okay too.